Hello friends, this is Durga again from IT Varsity. As part of this video, under CCS Spark and Hadoop Developer, I'll be covering creating a table in the Hive Metastore using the Avro file format and an external schema file. So here there are two things. One, the data file format itself. So the data should be in Avro file, and then it should be pointing to external schema file. For that, we have already ran scoop import as part of the last video, and the scoop import would have created directories under this location. So if you go to the scoop-demo.txt under my GitHub account, I have suggested to import all tables using as Avro data file to this location, and you will find all the files here. You can validate by running this command at command line, Hadoop fs-ls user hive warehouse retail underscore stage dot db and hit enter. You will see directory for each of the tables, and if you go to one of the tables and see what kind of files they have, you will see that they have Avro file format. So using these Avro files, we have to create tables in Hive Metastore. And while defining the table, we have to provide the external schema file. And after the scoop import in my last video, I have shown you that it will create .avsc files like this. So you have AVSC file for each of them. For each of the file that is imported from MySQL to HDFS, you will find a AVSC file for this. And if you look at one of the AVSC files, it has the structure of the file in JSON format. So whatever data is stored in Avro, the structure is defined in this AVSC file, which is schema for our data. So what they're trying to what they're asking as part of the certification is to create an external to create a table in the Hive Metastore using the Hive Avro file format. So the Avro file format is in this location in HDFS. And then we have these AVSC files created when we actually did the scoop import. And using this AVSC file, we can create the table pointing to this. So for that, first we need to copy these files to HDFS, not the same location where we have data. We can copy it to anywhere. So for that, I'm creating a directory called retail stage under user cloudera retail stage. You can give whatever name you want. Hit enter. I'm giving retail stage because in my GitHub code, in hiveddl.txt file, you can see that I am pointing my Avro schema to this location of user cloudera retail stage. Hence, I have created retail stage directory here. And now I am copying these files. Copy from local. I want to copy all AVSC files, not others. And the target location is user cloudera retail underscore stage. And hit enter. Now we have, let's take one example. Take the example of departments table. You have the data file in Avro format in this location, user hive warehouse retail stage dot db departments. And you can see that it returns the output as and the files are off with Avro extension, and you can cat them, and you can see that it will be in binary format with the schema at the head of the file. And then you have the schema itself under user cloudera retail underscore stage. Okay, this is the location where we have the schemas, which is with the .avsc extension. You can see one of them is for departments table. So now we have to connect these two. For that, we'll be using Hive. So I am already in Hive, and make sure that you switch to retail underscore stage, because this is the location where we are trying to create these tables. And when you run show tables, it is not showing anything here. Now I'll be creating external table. You can create managed table also, but when you create managed table, when you drop the table, data also will be gone. So it's up to your choice. If you want to create external table or managed table, it doesn't matter. But make sure that you understand, when you create managed table, when you drop the table, the data will be gone. If you want to retain, and if you want to, if you do not want to tightly couple between the structure, which is defined in create table command, and the data has to be loosely coupled. And if you drop the structure, if you don't want to touch the data, then you have to create it as external table. And now you can run all these commands from categories to, there are six tables up to products. Just copy paste them. And run it here. So all the tables are created. It says unable to read schema. Okay, the reason is the paths are not correct. In our case, the file names are scoop underscore import underscore categories, scoop underscore import underscore customers, like that. There is scoop import prefix for each of the file names, and we are only referring with order items.avsc or customers.avsc without that scoop import prefix. For that, what I will do is I will say Hadoop fs mv user cloudera retail stage scoop import categories.avsc to categories user cloudera retail stage categories.avsc and hit enter. Now I will just create for one and validate first, then I will make the changes to rest of the stuff. So paste it here. Okay, drop table categories. It is seems it is already created, that's why it is failing. Okay, here in this case I have scoop underscore import, but others I don't have. That's weird. Anyway, let me rename it back for categories alone. So make sure you have names intact. What I will do is I will update the script so that it have scoop import in them, or I will make sure scoop import is not there in them. So I will choose one of the ways. Okay, now it is copied or moved, and now I can create the table for categories and paste. Now the table is created, and I can run select star from categories, hit enter. You can see the data. So the actual data is in Avro data file format, and scoop actually created AVSC file for you. So you used that AVSC file to define it as schema. And there is another way to get the schema using Avro tools, which I have shown as part of the previous video. So if you, even if you, in the exam, if they give a file in Avro data file format and ask you to create a table, Hive table or Impala table in Hive Metastore using that data file, you can use the Avro tools, extract the schema, and then you can apply the schema either by using Avro schema URL by copying file to this location, or you can also use Avro schema literal and you can copy the schema inline to the command. So let's take the example of departments in this case. And instead of using Avro schema URL as part of table properties, I will try to use something called Avro schema literal. Paste literal. And then we have already copied the schema of AVSC here. By using Avro tools, we extracted the schema. So I'm using that one. Even scoop import will get the same thing or similar thing, if not same. So I just have to copy this and paste it here. Okay, and hit enter and semicolon. Now the table is created with the schema being in literal, and this schema is extracted using Avro tools get schema command as part of the previous video. And you can actually go to departments using select query and you can see the results here. Okay, so that's how you can actually create the tables on Avro data file using Avro schema, either by file or using literal. And now let us interpret the schema itself. So the schema definition is on JSON format. There are other formats also Avro supports, but for exam we just need to be familiar with JSON. We don't need to be familiar with other formats like IDL. So in this we are saying that each line or each the table will have a type of records, and then we have given the name. That name is not the table name. Table name is here, and then document. So it's kind of a description, and then we have given fields. Fields takes an array, and in the array you can define each field at a time. You can define type. You can define column. And if you don't want to have null values, if you want to have null values in the data, you can have. If you want to define default, you can have default property also. So you can actually modify the structure with other features for fields. It takes name, type, and probably they might ask you about default also. I will show you how you can leverage default as part of schema evolution in future, but for now just remember that you can even define defaults for the fields. And then column name is the one which will be represented as column name. And if you see in the create external table, we didn't specify the column names because the column names are fetched from here. Or you can also define column names here, ignoring column names in the field section. And once you define all the fields, you have to close the array. Each field has to be separated by comma using within the curly braces. And then once all the fields are defined, you have to close the array. So this table have two fields, and that's the structure on our data, which is in Avro file format in HDFS. And we have linked these two by using this create external table. If you want, you can remove external and make it manage table also. Okay, that being said, let me see if they are emphasizing anything in the syllabus. Create a table in Hive Metastore using the Avro file format and an external schema file. We will also test it against Impala. We have created the table in Hive and we ran the queries also for both categories as well as departments. Now we will launch Impala shell. It is not started, so let me start the Impala shell here. Let me restart it. So once you restart, make sure you exit from Impala shell and start again. Now it is started. Now I can say show databases. We need to use retail stage. Show tables. You can see it has categories and departments. Select stars from categories and you can get the data, and also select star from departments. And also all the scripts which are here, you can run even from Impala. For example, if you want to create orders table, you can use Impala also, paste it. And here I have to say scoop import orders, that is the prefix for my AVSC file, and then close the bracket, semicolon. There is some syntax error. Okay, the SERDE it is using is Hive based SERDE. Instead I have to use Impala SERDEs. Actually I can just say stored as euro. I don't need to specify all these things. So create table orders, copy, paste, stored as euro, and then this is my location, copy, paste, enter, and then I have to specify the table properties, copy and paste, and hit enter. Now the table is created, and you can see describe formatted orders to see how the table is structured. You can see, okay, it is still using Hive, but I think when it comes to creating tables in Impala, it does not take some of the keywords that are there in Hive, but you can safely use stored as euro and create the table here. And now you can actually do select star from orders, limit 10, and hit enter, and you can see the data without any issues. Okay, so this is how you can actually create the table in Hive Metastore, and you can access with using both Hive as well as Euro, sorry, Hive as well as Impala. Now the same table can be accessed even in Hive. Select star from orders, limit 10, hit enter. You can see the data here. We created in Metastore using Impala, which is accessible in Hive. So you can use the same command, same table to be created in one Metastore, which is accessible to both Impala and Hive, and also it can be accessible using this Spark also, and you can query from those tables. That being said, we will see rest of the stuff in further videos. And there are two more items. One is using partitioning for Hive, and also another important feature in Euro, which is called a schema evolution, will be covered as part of next two videos. I hope you are enjoying the content on my channel. If you like this video, please click on the like button. If you want to provide the feedback, please use the comment section of the video. If you if you have any technical questions, please use Stack Overflow tag by tagging your questions appropriately. And if you want to discuss further on Hadoop certifications, you can actually join my LinkedIn group called ITversity Hadoop Certifications. And if you have not subscribed to my channel yet, please do so. You will get to see a lot more content like this over time. Thank you. Bye.